In lecture 11, we're looking at an introduction to digital control. Digital control is when the control law is implemented in the form of a digital algorithm. The algorithm can then be in turn be implemented as a program by a microprocessor, microcontroller, or a computer. So the block diagram shows a control system in which a controller is in the form of a digital algorithm. The digital algorithm is a function of the current error, previous error values, and previous control values. The previous error and control values are stored in memory. The microprocessor or microcontroller can then fetch these values from memory, read the current error value, then apply the algorithm to generate a new control value that is going to be sent to the process. In a clock-driven algorithm, the program runs at regular intervals. That is at intervals 0, T, 2T, 3T, 4T, and so on until infinity. T is the time between successive runs of the program, and it is equal for all the intervals. The notation that we use to represent errors when dealing with the digital control is EKT represents the current error value, EK minus 1, the previous error value, EK minus 2, second previous error value, EK minus 3, third previous error value, and so on. The same approach is used for the control values. UKT is for the current control value, UK minus 1, the previous control value, UK minus 2, the second previous error value, and so on until you get to the number of values that you require. So this is a diagram to just illustrate using the error values. The general format of an algorithm is in the form of a linear difference equations. The terms B0, B1, B2 up to Bm, A1, A2, A3 up to An are known as coefficients or constants. The terms in the form of B are the coefficients for the current error value and the previous error values. Then the coefficients in terms of A are the coefficients for the previous control values. Control systems that contain digital controllers are effectively digital or discrete in nature. The signals that are in these systems are in the form of sequences. Digital control systems are analyzed using methods that are used to analyze discrete systems. In other words, they are analyzed using Z transforms. We will note that for the analysis of continuous control systems, we're using Laplace transforms. For digital control systems, we're going to use Z transforms, and we apply them in a way that is similar to the way in which we apply Laplace transforms. So before you proceed with the lecture, it will be important to make sure that you have got sufficient knowledge of Z transforms and how to use them in various contexts. A Z transfer function is a Z transform expression that models the relationship between an output and an input of a system or of a block. In general, it is expressed as gz equals yz over xz, where yz is the output and xz is the input. So it can be manipulated so that it becomes a ratio of two polynomials in the form qz over pz, where qz is the numerator polynomial and pz is the denominator polynomial. The characteristic polynomial is the denominator polynomial, that is pz. Then poles are roots of pz equals zero, i.e. they are roots of the characteristic equation. Zeros are roots of the expression qz equals to zero. Let's consider here a digital algorithm given in the form of a difference equation. Using the properties of the Z transform, we transform the difference equation into the Z domain. Then using algebraic manipulations, we obtain the ratio uz over ez. And that ratio uz over ez is equivalent to the Z transfer function of the digital algorithm. The Z transfer function of the algorithm is expressed as dz. As we have seen earlier on, the control algorithm can be expressed as a difference equation in some general format. We can use Z transforms to manipulate that general expression into a general format of a transfer function for the digital controller. So we have done that in that slide, that we obtain the general form of the control algorithm dz. I recommend that you do these questions before you proceed to the next lecture.